Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
Mine's working.
Oh.
Is yours working?
No.
Are the mics on?
No, it's 2, 3, 4, 5 wrong. 2, 3, 5.
Hi guys. We currently only have one mic. We are having some technical difficulties, unfortunately. We are going to start off with Sorry Baby, I'm Not Sorry. That's ironic. that's the song that we'll be playing. Yeah. All right. Listen up while we figure this stuff out.
Wait, message for the next question. When someone comes to the office, I'll remember the next question. Unless they're back already.
Hello, we're back.
Hello, this is Sunny Side Up with Riley and Jelly. This is Jelly speaking.
Woo!
And that's Riley wooing. today we have our guest Azriel, and then we'll have another guest coming, but he's a little late. Azriel, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hello, I'm Azriel.
She is another student at NJIT with us. We are all in the architecture program.
What is our topic for today?
Our topic for today is art as a stress relief and
expressing yourself as
expressing art. Yourself as art.
Anyway, we're gonna go to our next song, Serial Killers by Human Zoo, while Jelly figures her stuff out.
Yeah. Okay. I'm all over the place today. Sorry, guys.
Good thing I recorded.
Oh, God.
Okay, let's do it.
Slice of pie. You got me. Hop, step into the midnight dark days. cold bath.
Hello. we're back sunny side up with Riley and Jelly, and then we also have our two guests, Dennis and Azriel.
Woo!
Yes, Dennis just got here. So what we'll be doing today is talking about art, and our first activity is a drawing challenge. If everyone would like to grab a pencil and a piece of paper.
And for everyone at home, you can play this along.
Yes. We're gonna start doing a drawing challenge. Riley, would you like to explain the goal of this?
Okay, so for the length of the next song, your goal is to draw something that represents you or makes you happy.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah, so get creative, draw animals, draw yourself, draw whatever's in front of you, anything cool or anything boring too. That would be fun too, right?
Yeah.
Just draw. Get creative, have fun, and enjoy this next song.
Azriel, do you want to introduce the next song?
This song is, this goes out to Teresa and Allie, who requested it, Rocky Amadeus.
Okay. Sweet. You ready? 3, 2,
draw.
1, go. Der große Staat, es war in Vienna, wo alles tat. Hatte Schulden, denn trank, doch ihn liebten alle Frauen. Und jede rief, na kann man Rock Me Amadeus. War Superstar, war populär, war so exaltiert, because hatte Flair. War ein Virtuose, war ein Rockidol. Und alles rief, na kann man Rock Me Amadeus. Es war in Wien, no plastic money anymore, die Banken gegen ihn. Woher die Schulden kamen, war wohl jedermann bekannt. War ein Mann der Frauen, Frauen liebten seinen Punk. War ein Superstar, war so populär, war zu exaltiert, genau das war sein Flair. War ein Virtuose, war ein Rockidol. Und alles ruft noch heute, Captain Rock Me Amadeus.
And that's time up, everyone. So we're going to be posting our little sketches on our Instagram. But if you would like to hear us talk about what they are, Riley, would you like to describe what you drew?
I did my house in the Poconos. Ooh. It makes me very happy. It's spend a lot of time with family.
Nice. Are you, you're going, so we have spring break, coming up. Are you going home?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. So you'll get to go get cabin fever?
Maybe. Okay. Let's see. Azriel.
All right. I drew my most stress-relieving thing, which is my cat, Croissant, sitting in a recliner with a nice hot cup of tea. And then I recently discovered that I'm really good at drawing shrimp without even looking at one. So I also drew a shrimp in a shrimp tank. Because I'm going to be acquiring some shrimp soon.
Yo, I made shrimp last week. And I ate it.
I'm going to be not letting you near my pet shrimp.
But... shrimp is good.
Dennis, what did you draw?
I drew a dog with the devil wings and Liam right next to it. Wait, even though I'm a cat person, I feel like dog represent my quality as a person more. And I drew with a devil wings also because people say I'm brutally honest. So I just drew a devil wings that represent my brutal honesty.
Oh, nice. That makes you happy?
Yeah.
Happy. Cool. Nice. I drew a few sketches. They're really silly.
A few? Jelly?
Yeah. Well, I got... because I couldn't make up my mind, so I drew a few. I drew, like, a smiley face, and then a really pointy nose, and then I used, like, purple and blue because I like purple and blue. Then I drew a boat because there's a painting of a boat in front of me, so yeah, and I use blue for that. Yeah, purples, blues, smiley.
Okay.
So,
are we ready for the animal facts?
I think so. So, what's our animal fact of the day, Azriel? What's our animals? What's our animal?
Elephant.
Yes. Yeah, it's an elephant. Our first fact, Riley. Would you like to say that?
So, elephants' perception of humans is how we see, like, dogs or puppies. So, elephants think that humans are the most adorable thing in the world, basically.
Yeah. Like, I look
like
at...
like, they want to cuddle us.
How do you know that?
There was probably a study.
Scientific research.
I don't know if I trust them.
You don't trust... do you? I think you should do the research for yourself, though. Because, like, you can't believe people. So don't even believe us. No, we don't know what we're talking about. No, if you want to fact check, go study some elephants, please.
Jelly did get fact checked for fat shaming a hippo.
Yeah, that was on our previous episode. Yeah, I accidentally fat shamed a hippo, and I will try not to fat shame elephants.
I know the other fact about elephants.
You know another fact about
they
elephants?
They have empathy.
They have empathy?
They have empathy.
Where did you find
how
this
so?
Out?
You know the difference between empathy and sympathy?
What?
I think they have both. Like, sympathy is actually feel like being inside of their shoes and then actually to feel what they feel like. Let's say if I trip into a pound of water, they'll actually think of themselves feeling the pound of water and then picture what it feels like. That is sympathy. And they have that.
And then empathy.
And empathy? Empathy just like, yeah, I feel bad for you. But they don't.
Wait, what? Did we just...
A solid wheel, though. I think we just... Jelly can fact check this.
Do you want me to? What's up with this fact checking today? Let's just switch to another fact about elephants. They can paint.
They actually can paint.
They can.
They can. A zoo had a painting elephant.
Yeah.
And if they would, like, pay for commissioning for paintings from this elephant.
I would pay for an elephant painting. You can also go on YouTube and, like, look up elephants painting.
But could they understand it?
It's, like, the cutest thing.
Can they understand it? I mean, if they have empathy, they can understand a painting.
This one elephant drew, like, a flower.
A flower.
But was it just by chance or was it on purpose?
Or is it, like, remembering the pattern?
By chance or by
elephants
choice.
Have great memory.
They do have great
They
memories.
Can, like, remember who you are if you're their caretaker, mm-hmm. which I think is the cutest thing.
Elephants can also sense, like, approaching clouds.
Yeah.
Which is really cool. They basically can, like, hear with their feet.
hear with their feet.
Well, when you're that large,
they literally like hear, like they feel the vibrations.
I mean, and we also hear our own bones like cracking, right?
Yeah.
Instead of our body.
Well, it like snap. Your bones snap.
We have like air pockets in the joint.
Yeah.
Right? Mm. So they can hear themselves walking.
Well, okay, I guess you could think about it as if, like, you know, like when you're chewing food or like something crunchy,
yeah,
and you could hear it in your head,
yeah,
because your eardrums are like right next to your jaw,
yeah,
right? It might be something like that, but like from their feet.
From their feet.
This is all guessing.
they like, it's kind of like echolocation,
yeah,
for like a whale. Right.
Also, they can echolocation
some. Basically, they feel like the vibrations.
Wait. So what is it? Wait. I thought elephants have really big ears, though.
They do, but they also can feel the vibrations so they of have the ground.
It's kind of like of how the others or for themselves
can like feel an earthquake.
I mean,
the vibrations of others.
Oh, others. Okay. Okay.
So they just have better senses than humans.
Yeah,
they're just better than humans.
Can you guys recognize your family's members on
footsteps?
Footsteps.
Yeah.
I mean.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Hermes footsteps.
Yeah, I mean, I can recognize.
Does she walk like an elephant?
She drags her right foot.
Is she limping?
Oh, wait, that's.
Is she limping?
She's just heavy on one foot. That's all.
Because I'm coming from the memory, a family of five, and I can recognize four other people's.
That's stepping. Cool.
I can easily understand my mother's, because every time she takes a step, sometimes a little fart comes out, you know?
No.
Oh my gosh.
Like, it's like walking on a whoopee cushion.
You're blasting your mom right now.
She's not watching. She's on an anniversary dinner. I love you, Mom. Anyway, should we go on to the next song?
Yeah. What is it? Judas?
Judas. By Lady Gaga.
Oh, yeah.
Who is this dedicated for, Azriel?
Oh, man. I didn't pick anyone for this
one. Croissant. Croissant, this one's for you. Yeah.
Yo, click the button.
I'm
So guys, how's your day been? What'd you guys do?
Went to site visit.
Yeah.
Site visit? Where'd you go?
The Meadowlands.
The Meadowlands? Oh yeah, you sent me the picture.
We saw some ducks.
You saw ducks? Did you take pictures of the ducks?
Is it geese?
And ducks. There was ducks there too.
I love ducks. They're amazing.
We make him birdwatch tower. And then I seen I saw the birds, only the geese.
I saw a lot of birds.
Yeah, I saw a lot of birds after that.
Cardinals, saw some blue jays.
Do you have some ideas for this project?
Oh yeah?
Yeah, but we're gonna gatekeep them.
Gatekeeping ideas? That is peak design. It's cool.
Jelly, how was your day?
It was alright. I was cramming for my midterm review. So I have the site, the Gowanus Canal site, and I was basically like, I'll share my idea because I already presented it. I cut my site and then like allowed for a water incision to come through my site, and building an ecology center like into the land, and then like allowing the water to go over so that the ecology center can like study it. I don't know if that made sense. I hope that did, but whatever. It went well. I explained it better during my review. I'm a little brain dead now, though.
So the topic today is art as expression, or like expressing yourself through art. So, Azriel, what does that mean to you?
I've gone through a lot of different stages with my art. I find that I have to like kind of rotate how I'm using it. I don't know. I feel like I'm delving more into expressing myself through it rather than just doing it to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely things like painting nails and stuff I've discovered is like good for like expression through art. Yeah, being more creative with paintings. I'm branching out from my normal lately.
Mm-hmm. And you have a painting account, right?
Yes, I do.
You guys should all go follow it.
Yeah, you guys should follow it. We did tag it in the Instagram post.
Yeah.
Dennis, what do you think it means to you?
Art.
Art.
Expressing yourself through art.
Expressing myself. I think the peak of my art was in elementary school. Even my technique got better, my art doesn't get better. Now in elementary school, I drew this picture where me and my grandma is on this gondola. And then I just add stuff. That whatever it feels like it, and then that for me that was really free. I got a lot of freedom doing it. It's pretty simple.
Mm-hmm.
I really never think about like what's the meaning of art. I mean, just perform, execute it well. You are not thinking about it. For me, that is art.
Mm-hmm. But you do like your studio projects, like you do hand drawn projects a lot. Do you feel like that helps express your ideas better than like Rhino and?
Yeah, I always been prefer hand drawing more than digital drawings because I think that does express my ideas better, especially this one. I really don't focus on the representation that much for this project because I think essentially just always comes down to your design. And just looking at all the draft and sketches you had before your final portrait goes down, like that... people can see from sketches and your axis of design. They can tell like how you came up with this shape more than really hardcore representation style. Yeah. And especially like when people got representation style get better, it always just came down to your design. So just prefer doing hand sketches now. I was hesitant about hand drawing my stuff, but until I realized like if you want to start your own firm, you're not gonna 3D design your own stuff for 4 hours and then wait for your employee to come in and say, ah, this is what I want. Instead, you're just gonna do like 3 minute sketches, tell them this is what you want, and then make them to do the rest of the drawings.
Yeah, like saves time.
Yeah, it does save time. And then once very often I got reminded by, like today I just got reminded by a YouTube channel that I should keep doing hand drawing instead of going to digital drawing. When you were doing presenting and get feedback from all the guest crit and your critic. Also, always doesn't feel like it's not rewarded, because like you spend 3 hours, I don't know, I spent 7 hours for 4 days straight before the final presentation, and then it doesn't feel rewarding. It doesn't feel worth it. So I feel rewarded to yourself, just for your achievement for yourself.
Yeah, and then sometimes you have to like create your own rewards.
Yeah, I create my own reward, and then you feel achievement. Don't try to find compliment from someone else.
Yeah, compliment yourself. Yeah. Love yourself. That's what expressing yourself is about. Loving yourself enough to wanting to express yourself.
Yes.
Azriel, I know someone told you some feedback on what they thought about this.
What is
I have a quote from another Dennis.
Another Dennis.
Another one.
My friend Ali's dad, he's very knowledgeable and very creative. He says, well, art is his ability to create something from something within himself that other people can view and hopefully like and enjoy, but can also persuade others to follow their inner artist by using music or art. He also says, not only do I create art to expand my mind and allow myself to create new ideas, that's not only for me, but for others.
Yeah. Wow.
Very wise.
There are so many forms of art, though, which, brilliant. Like, fascinates me so much. Like, music is my favorite. Then, like, painting, drawing,
dance. Even, like, fashion.
Yeah, dance, fashion.
That's a form
fashion.
Of art. That's a form of expressing yourself.
Furniture.
Furniture.
Buildings.
Poems.
Poetry.
Yeah.
Literature.
Honestly, anything could be art.
I think anything that you've created or, like made is a form of art.
So, Jelly.
Yes.
If you poop, is that art? Because you didn't make it.
It's your body's art, sure.
Wow.
if you want to look at it that way.
So everything is art.
Not everything, but like anything that you left your mark with. Like you can, like, I feel like one of the purposes of life is to like leave your mark and like.
So to poop?
No. What is with the pooping?
I'm sorry I brought this up.
But like you just, I don't know, make something and like hope that other people enjoy it.
Yeah, like the cave paintings.
Cave paintings,
like
yes.
That they left their mark.
Yeah. And like now, like later on in history, we have discovered the cave paintings.
So when we're extinct, people are gonna discover us.
Unless we're like out of the view of the universe.
No.
Is that pessimistic?
Yeah, this is sunny side up, Jelly.
Alright, well, sunny side up, side
anyway,
down.
On that note, this is $20 nosebleed. Bro! By Fallout Boy?
Fallout Boy! $20 nosebleed. Click the button, Riley.
Please let me in. Please let me in. The man keeps trembling. Sing.
We're back.
Yeah. Riley, would you like to pull up the question?
The Instagram poll?
Yeah, that we posted.
Okay, so our silly goose question of the week was, we posted a picture of flying elephants, like an art piece, and we said, what does this work remind you of, and how does it make you feel?
Yeah.
What does it do?
We got some very interesting responses. Jelly, I want to know how it made you feel.
I think I put, it makes me feel like the airhead that I am.
Yeah.
I think I'm a little bit of an
airhead. We got a lot of people who are very logical. They put flying elephants.
Yes. This is very accurate, I feel.
A silly little picture.
Silly little picture.
We got one person that put me when I win. That was interesting. And then...
No, like, you know, like, when you buffer?
Yeah.
Lucas buffers all the time. They're just buffering. My doggo.
And then this one really interests me. So I'm going to call this person out. Teresa, why did you put nostalgic for two floating fat elephants?
Dumbo!
Okay, well...
That would be a good answer, but I don't think that's the answer.
I have her reasoning behind this. She says it reminds her of youth, like that indescribable feeling that you only felt in summer 2007 that you can't get back.
Like, while you're, like, standing outside on a sidewalk eating a popsicle?
Probably.
Ooh, like the SpongeBob Pops.
Oh my god. Yes.
She seems like a SpongeBob Pop girl. SpongeBob Pop.
Yeah.
The ones that always never look like the picture.
Yeah. Like, you'd be missing an eye on the on the SpongeBob.
And then we have, for a serious question, if you were a color, what color would you be? So I'd let's be all answer that right now. You'd be purple?
Purple. Purple. Mm.
Dennis, what color would you be? You're hard and flat right now, man.
What?
He's hard in thought.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's too orange.
Different.
Orange?
Yeah.
Orange?
Okay.
I feel like as much as I want to say pink, I do feel like I resonate with like a neon orange. Ooh, so I neon. Guess it's kind of similar to Dennis, but I don't know.
But like neon.
He strikes me as like a burnt orange. Burnt orange. Not in a bad way.
A burnt orange.
I would be blue, obviously.
Blue, 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 blue,
blue, blue, blue. And we got some pretty good answers. We got blue, lots of purple, lots of blue, pink, aqua.
Aqua.
Really specific. And then
aqua. Magenta specific.
Someone put beans.
Was that Teresa?
No, it was Ren.
Oh, Ren was on our show last week.
Our guest from yesterday put, I mean last week. Yesterday. Not yesterday. It felt like yesterday, but he put beans.
Beans.
How does that make you feel?
Which kind of beans, though?
I feel like those baked, like, maple-y beans.
Baked beans?
Yeah.
Bushes baked beans?
Yeah.
But, like, what? Because there are, like, black beans, there are brown beans, there are white beans.
I don't know. I guess
color doesn't matter.
Yeah, maybe he was doing, like, more of a statement. Beans. Like, it's more of what's inside than the color
than
of the
than
bean.
What's on the outside, right? You gotta look deeper.
Yeah, he was being really symbolic with it, Ren. Good answer.
Symbolic.
Oh, he did confirm bush baked beans.
Oh, okay.
Baked beans. Biked beans.
What?
Biked beans. Sorry, I'm on loop. I'm looping myself.
Baked or refried beans? What are...
If I had to refry beans?
No. Like, do you prefer baked beans or refried beans?
Wait, refried?
Yeah, like the
Mexican beans.
Oh. I was like, if it's already cooked and you refry it. Like, that was... Okay.
I'm a baked bean type of gal.
I think baked beans are pretty solid.
Those with some, like, hamburgers. Some, like, barbecue.
Yeah. Or whatever beans that...
Corn on the cob.
They give you at Chipotle.
Those are just regular beans.
Yeah. I'm a regular
black
one.
Black beans or pinto beans?
Pinto. You give me a funny look. Do you not like the pinto beans?
I don't get beans in my Chipotle order.
Oh, okay.
Personally.
Not a bean person?
Only baked beans.
I know a bean expert. again, mentioning Teresa.
She's a bean expert?
She probably eats beans 3 times a day every day a week.
Wait, isn't there that, like, only childhood book that was, like, with the girl that refused to eat her, like,
Lima beans? Beans, right?
Lima beans? Is it lima beans? What is the difference between a lima bean and a just regular bean?
Teresa, are you there? Tell us the difference.
Nah, she's a beans and rice girl. So.
Beans and rice.
Beans and rice. But, like, you just throw a steak on anything, it'll taste better, too.
She says, loving the beans discourse. Please, more of this.
Oh, more of how do we get onto beans? Oh, this was Ren's goal.
It was his goal.
He wrote this in. He wrote in the beans.
Ren and Teresa need to meet, and then they give and talk each about other beans a can together. Of beans. Beans. That needs to happen on our podcast.
Everybody, come talk about beans. We should start a bean club.
No, that's kind of weird.
Yeah.
I feel like Stockton would have a bean club, probably.
Why just Stockton? Why not Cornell? Stockton. I feel like Cornell would also have a bean club. Just because of the name. Not because it's Cornell.
What?
Okay, let's get away from this bean. What song's next, Riley?
Next song is This River is Wild by The Killers.
You know what else is wild? Your mom.
I was gonna say that, but Jelly, I hate you.
Yeah.
We're back.
Hi.
Sadly,
nice voice crack.
The night has come to a close end. We have one more song. What do you guys want to say? Your last words.
Don't you have an update about the beans?
Oh, yeah, I do have a bean update.
We can't forget about the beans.
So, lima beans are a legume. Beans are beans.
Wow.
Yeah, so they're not all the same bean. Just know that beans are different. There are many beans.
There's many types.
Many types of beans. Beans and it's are okay like that they're different.
Beans are like people.
Mm. And art.
And I think art beans are just beans.
Art.
Yo, can bean be art?
Anything. Teresa, this is your calling.
Bean art. Bean art.
Crochet bean art. She crochets, so.
How do you crochet a bean?
You should, like, Teresa will figure
it out. Wait, you can crochet a bean.
And fill it with beans, too.
Fill it with beans.
Dennis, do you have any last words for the podcast?
Hope you guys have a great spring break.
Yeah.
Very good.
Oh, we're not having an episode next week.
Yeah, we aren't. Spring break. We will post our recorded episodes, though.
Yeah.
Over the break.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You can watch this goal. One and more.
Yeah.
For all of Azriel's friends, you can make her listen to it.
Woohoo. 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 All right, have a good night.
We'll end the night with a song of Azriel's choice. Goodbye. Goodbye. By Oingo Boingo.
Because goodbye, so.
Goodbye.
Now click the button.
Goodbye, everybody.
Hey.